Bacche di Nubisco Valzi, dove dice: «Ujemno vas prosimo da isklopite prenosne telefone in da obobiskih prireditev pustite doma ure, ki oddajajo zvočne signale. Sporočamo vam tudi, da je brez posebnega dovoljenja strogo prepovedano fotografiranje ter vsakršno snemanje koncertov in predstav. Drug drugemu omogočite zbrano spremljanje odrskega dogodka. Hvala.»
Harryja Potterja bi bilo treba ubiti.
Sixth type. To be among the masses, one or an ordinary non-communist. This is a seventh type. To see someone arguing the interests of the masses and yet not feel indignant or dissuade or stop him or reason with him, but to allow him to continue. This is an eighth type. To work half-heartedly without a definite plan or direction. To work perfunctorily and muddle along. So long as one remains a monk, one goes on tolling the bell. This is a ninth type. To regard oneself as having rendered great service to the revolution, to pride oneself on being a veteran, to disdain minor assignments while being quite unequal to major tasks, to be slipshod at work and slack in study. This is a tenth type. To be aware of one's own mistakes and yet make no attempt to correct them, taking a liberal attitude towards oneself. This is an 11th type. We could name more, but these 11 are the principal types. They are all manifestations of liberalism. Liberalism is extremely harmful in a revolutionary collective. It is a corrosive which eats away unity, undermines cohesion, causes apathy, and creates dissension. It robs the revolutionary ranks of compact organization and strict discipline, prevents policies from being carried through, and alienates the party organizations from the masses which the party leads. It is an extremely bad tendency. Liberalism stems from petty bourgeois selfishness. It places personal interests first and the interests of the revolution second, and this gives rise to ideological, political, and organizational liberalism. People who are liberals look upon the principles of Marxism as abstract dogma. They approve of Marxism, but are not prepared to practice it or to practice it in full. They are not prepared to replace their liberalism by Marxism. These people have their Marxism, but they have their liberalism as well. They talk Marxism but practice liberalism. They apply Marxism to others, but liberalism to themselves. They keep both kinds of goods in stock and find a use for each. This is how the minds of certain people work. Liberalism is a manifestation of opportunism and conflicts fundamentally with Marxism. It is negative and objectively has the effect of helping the enemy. That is why the enemy welcomes its preservation in our midst. Such being its nature, there should be no place for it in the ranks of the revolution. We must choose Marxism, which is positive in spirit, to overcome liberalism, which is negative. A communist should have largeness of mind, and he should be staunch and active, looking upon the interests of the revolution as his very life and subordinating his personal interests to those of the revolution. Always and everywhere he should adhere to principle and wage a tireless struggle against all incorrect ideas and actions, so as to consolidate the collective life of the party and strengthen the ties between the party and the masses. He should be more concerned about the party and the masses than about any private person, and more concerned about others than about himself. Only thus can he be considered a communist.
Čudovita mučeniška smrt sedmih makabejskih bratov z materjo. Kralj se je razsrdil in ukazal razbeliti ponve in kople. Brž, ko so bili razbeljeni, je ukazal temu, ki je zanje govoril, odrezati jezik, potegniti po skitskem običaju z glave kožo in odsekati v nanje ude pred očmi ostalih bratov in mater. Ko je bil že povsem pohabljen, ga je velel še živega spraviti k ognju in ponvi peči. Ko je prvi tako umrl, so peljali drugega k mučenju. Potegnili so mu z glave kožo z lasmi in ga vprašali, ali hočeš jesti, preden ti mučimo ud za udom. Zatem so mučili tretjega. Na zahtevo je takoj pomolil jezik in srčno stegnil roke. Ko je tudi ta umrl, so prav tako četrtega mučili in trpinčili. Tako na to so pripeljali petega in ga trpinčili. Zatem so pripeljali šestega in ga mučili. Najbolj mučeniške smrti je umrl sedmi. Neizmerno čudovita pa je in slavnega spomina vredna mati, ki je videla, kako je v času enega dne umrlo sedem sinov. Ženska nrav je krepila z moško srčnostjo in govorila: ne vem, kako ste se pojavili v mojem telesu, tudi vam nisem jaz dala duha in življenja in slehernega prvin nisem jaz sklenila. Zamenjava žena je televizijski resničnostni šov, ki podira rekorde gledanosti v Združenih državah Amerike. Dve družini si za teden dni zamenjata ženi. Ena takih zamenjav je povzročila pravo dramo v družini, ki je dotedaj živela mirno predmestno življenje z ženo in materjo, debelo in verno. Družina, v katero je prišla ob zamenjavi, ni bila verna, s čimer se nikakor ni hotela sprijazniti. Druga žena, privlačne še zunanjosti, se je skušala vživeti v življenje krščanske družine. Družinske prijateljice je najbolj zanimalo, v kaj veruje. Ko so se prepričale, da ni kristjanka, so jo popolnoma odklonile. Po koncu zamenjave nastopi trenutek, ko se posvojeni ženi vrneta k svojima družinama. Otroci nestrpno pričakujejo mater. Vrata se sunkoma odpro in žena plane v hišo. Še preden se z vso težo vrže na kavč, začne histerično kričati. Od samega besa se trese, vstane in se znova zvrne na kavč, krivi z rokami, njen obraz je zaripel in spačen od nebrzdanega dretja. Nočem denarja, hočem svojega boga in svojo družino, jaz sem božja bojevnica. Krenek snemalni ekipin jo začne poditi iz hiše. Takoj ven iz moje hiše vsi, ki ne verujete v Boga. V Jezusovem imenu vsi ven. Obrne se k otrokom. Ste se pogovarjali o astrologiji? Je koga hipnotizirala? Vsako noč se molila za vas. Mož jo osuplo gleda, ona nadaljuje. V hišo je pripeljala temne sile. Vse je en sam kult, vse je obsedel hudič. Z mislijo na ženo, ki jo je samo za teden dni zamenjala v njeni hiši, se debela žena nikakor ne more sprijazniti. Njeno ljubosumje se nadaljuje.
There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, people who love Jesus. There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, love Jesus. There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, love Jesus. There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, love Jesus. There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, love Jesus. There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, love Jesus. There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, love Jesus. There are two kinds of people who love Jesus, love Jesus. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't. There are two kinds of people in the world. People who love Jesus and people who don't.
There are two kinds of people.
Vsi se samo zabavate. Ponoči ustavi in proseče piska, da bi ga pustili naprej. Kaj se je zgodilo? Le poglej, tik pred strojem gori rdeča lučka. To je znak, da vlak ne sme naprej, sicer bo katastrofa. Šele, ko bo ugasnila rdeča in se prižgala zelena luč, bo smel varno zavoziti na postajo. Gorje, ko bi se vlakovodja ne zmenil za znamenje. Razbil bi se on in potniki. Tak signal na vaši življenjski poti je vaša vest. Ta vam v nevarnem trenutku pravi. Stoj, ne naprej, sicer bo katastrofa. V dneh, ko je zlo tako narasto in ko ograja okoli domačega vrta ni več tako visoka, da bi se dekleta mogla očuvati zapeljevanje in hudobije, je dvakrat važno, da se obrnemo do posameznega dekleta in mu zakličemo. Vzgajaj se sama. Bodi celo apostol med enakimi. Na tebi je, da si dobra. Tako boš poroštvo srečne bodočnosti pojedinih in ljudstva, ki ostaja za nami. Mladini pripada bodočnost. Ne vedno dekle je izrodek in čudo svojega spola. Pobožna so dekleta bolj po moški, ker so po naravi šipkejše in slabotnejše in dobro vedo, kako so odvisne od Boga. Že ste videli, da sem v pripovedovanju prišla do važne točke, do tiste, ki je v vašem mladem življenju najbolj kočljiva. V vašem telesu so se začele buditi čisto posebne strasti. Ne čista sila, to je tisti črv, ki razjeda drevo pri korenini, da se ne more lepo razvijati, da cvet je vene na njem. Fatje, vi, ki čutite v sebi novo moč, uporabite jo proti tej uničevalki mladosti. Naletiš na napis prepovedana pot. Tak napis je postavil sam najvišji gospod in kršitelj je tudi že strašno kaznoval. Nihče nima pravice premikati njegovih mejnikov. Ostanimo pri vlaku. Ali si v vozovih nad oknom daj opazil kljuko z napisom zasilna zavora? Kaj bi bilo, ko bi iz radovednosti ali zato, ker se ne znaš premagati, potegnil za kljuko? Vlak bi se sunkoma ustavil, zavrl bi ga, zlorabil bi zavoro in kaznovali bi te pa občutno. Veš kaj, tudi v tvojem telesu so naprave, ki ni dovoljeno zlorabljati jih. Bog je to prepovedal. Pa morda kar tako zaradi kapric? Nikakor, ampak zato, ker tako mora biti. Ker je tako dobro in potrebno za našo naravo. Nečistost škoduje. Zato je prepovedano.
Thank you.
misionarno poslanstvo še ni izpolnjeno. Ameriški imperializem še živi, prav tako japonski. Posestniki, domači kapitalisti in njihovi lakaji v Južni Koreji so ostali nedotakljeni. Dokler bo obstajal sovražnik, moramo revolucijo nadaljevati in jo nenehno prenašati na nove generacije. Poznavanje markacij, napisanih tabel, puščic in varnostnih naprav. Temeljni znak za označevanje poti je okrogla markacija, rdeč kolobar okrog belega kroga. Razpotja in ostri ovinki so označeni smernimi puščicami. Poleg njih najdemo tudi črte, in sicer rdečo, belo, rdečo ali vsaj rdeče, belo črto, včasih pa tudi samo rdeče ali samo bele črte. Te črte so često vzrok nesporazuma, ker z eno ali več vzporednih črt gozdari označujejo meje svojih revirjev. Nekaj takih črt pa je ostalo tudi na planinskih poteh. Napisane ali orientacijske table so postavljene na začetku poti in na razpoti. Praviloma so rdeče, napisi pa so beli. Kjer je možno, je markacija v višini odraslega človeka. Pot je seveda treba markirati v obeh smereh.